Okay, we're back. We have all of our file folders cut. We have everything inked. We have all of our mats cut, and we have the templates cut for our inside mats for the decorative paper. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to glue the little mats, and you can make these 3 inches, 4 inches, however long you want to go inside of our pocket. We really only have to have enough so that when this page comes up and glues to it here, it's going to cover it up. So just a couple of inches. So we have all of these tab mats cut as well. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our first two file folders. And if you want to go through and number them, or if it's an easier to mark, you know, what size your mats are, I went through and marked mat A, B, C, D, and then I went through each page and wrote, okay, mark mat A goes here, B goes here, C goes here, D goes here. Just because it's easier for me, I wouldn't get as confused, but whatever works for you. So we've got our first file folder. The tab is on this side. Here's our inside. This is the part we're going to glue to here. Now we've got our mat that we're going to be our liner for our pocket, and we're going to take our glue and we're going to glue around the edge this way. And glue it so that you've got a nice border of your black stain showing all the way around. See how nice that looks. And I use baby wipes. In fact, I just bought baby wipes, and I think I got them from our family dollar store. I'd never been in it before. Don't remember, they were a dollar. But they're really nice and heavy and wet. I was real surprised, so I have to get back and get some more of those. Okay, now when we glue this to this, now see we've got that nice liner on there. So this is what we're going to see. Now this is our another folder, our next folder. This is our inside. And now here's our the part we're going to glue. And here's the next folder again. And we're going to glue this to this, this way, to create our pocket. So we're going to mat this edge. We've cut our little mat. And we're going to glue it right here. This glue doesn't give you a lot of wiggle room for moving it around, but it's real strong, and I love the way that it holds everything in place. Now I'm gonna pop this up just to make sure before I really push that down too hard. And now see what I've done? I didn't go down on my ink far enough on the sides, so that folder is going to show. So here you go. I'm going to pull this up and ink a little bit further down on both sides to make sure that that doesn't show when I press this down. So there's key. Go down about an inch. I'm going to run my heat gun for just a second. So you want to make sure that you come down far enough. You can always touch it up later, but it's easier if you do it beforehand. And then when I pop this over and we glue it down in a minute, now see I don't have any of that manila folder showing on either side. Okay, so that's our next one. We're going to fold it over. Here's our inside. And now here's our next one. And here's our mat. This is going to pull up to this, and this is going to create our pocket. And I think, let's pull this up now and just make sure that I've inked this far enough. And I have it. I have on that side, but see over here? See? see how the manila is showing. So I want to make sure that I take my distress ink down far enough. Let's do just be on the safe side. We'll go down a little bit further on that side too. And heat it. Okay, much better. Now when I put this in, it's going to fit just perfectly. Okay, so if you had just straight edges, you know, you didn't have all these curves that your file folders have, it wouldn't really matter about your mats as much. But because of the curving, and you see here on this edge, it has a little tweaky curve, I like it to follow the general look of what the folder was. That's why I think if you make the templates and cut them all ahead of time, that makes it really good. Okay, now I've gone ahead for the sake of time and I've matted all the rest of them. So see, they're all matted here and the rest of the book is all glued together. So that's going to be the next thing. You could mat these if you wanted to before, or you could glue it together and then mat them. I would say you've got your templates, you know what size you're going to cut. I would glue it. That way it's much easier visual to know what you're going to be putting your decorative pages on. So let's go back to the front of our book. Well, let's go back to the last one we matted. And now this file folder is going to glue to this file folder. The key is to make sure that these line up, because this is what's going to glue to your spine, and the more even you have that, the better it's going to glue and hold into your spine. So what I want to do is I want to glue, you can glue them off the two sides, or you can glue on all three. It doesn't matter. But you're only gluing on the sides because remember, this is going to be a pocket when we get done. So we're going to lift this up. We're going to make sure that we have this lined up. I know you can't see, but you will in a minute. Lined up really good with the sides like this. And the bottom, have my wet baby wipe here to clean up all my messes. And there we go. Make sure that we have that. I gotta turn it this way, make sure here. For some reason, it doesn't look like it wants to line up. And you gotta figure, you're working with file folders. You're not working with precise things. You may be off a little bit here and there. So you do the best you can do. Trim it up if you need to afterwards. Okay. So now we have just made a pocket. Now we're going to take the next one. This side and this side. We're going to glue them together and that's going to form our next pocket. We're going to put the glue on the three edges, leaving the top open, so that will be our pocket. Okay. Now, make sure that your bottom is lined up. That's the most important thing. Your bottom is lined up here, very good. And your sides. And I told you I was a messy Marvin. That's why I don't think do things in real time very often here. Okay, but I hit it down so I can try to get that as flat as can be across the bottom. There we go. Okay, so now we have our next pocket formed. Okay, and now the last one, see, this is the very front of our book. This is our last pocket we're forming. We can glue this one together. In fact, I think I'll put it on this side because this is the side that glues down, and then I won't be putting too much glue further up the side than what it's supposed to really be going. Maybe eliminate some of the mess here. You could use ATG or a sticky strip or something. The only thing with ATG is if there's a little bit of that tape there, when you start putting things in your pocket, it, because it's sticky and doesn't dry, your things can, that you slide in the pocket, can stick to them and snag. So I prefer using the wet glue. Okay, we've lined it up on all three sides, and there we have. Okay. Now, this is what we're going to glue to our spine to form our book. Here's the front. This is our first file folder, the inside. We've created a pocket. Our next folder, we've created the next pocket, and so forth and so on. And now we have 12 folders. See, I'll have to go back here because I've got glue on it. But everything's fixable. Never fear, you can always cover up your goobers. Okay, here we go, all the way through. And now, if I did this right, we should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 pockets. Okay, we're going to stop there, and the next one, I'll show you how we're going to put it in the book.